Hello, welcome to freeexcellearn.com. It is my Excel video tutorial number 15, and this is the tutorial for how to use a multi-column list box as like grid. And I am now continue this tutorial. Okay, now I am writing the code of load data, that is when it is when the user form will be load, on that time the data will be appear from sheet 1 to list box, all list box. Okay, as there is list box 1, so it will show data on list box 1. So the remarks is for load data to list box. So the code will be, at first I will be initialize the A row position. A row position will be 2, and what is A row position I will discuss you later. And I will write a loop. The loop name will be y, and its position will be 0 to why it is position will be 0, its position will be 0, I will also discuss it later. E row a minus 3, all these things I will discuss later. Next, and for this I have to add data to my list box 1, list box 1 dot add item. Okay, and after that here me is user form. Okay, me dot list box 1 dot list, and which list position? The list position will be y cell and 0 column. Okay, and here is everything is 0 0, that means equal to cells position cells cells equal to a row comma the column will be from A. Okay, this is the code. On the same way, I fill up all the data, all the code, sorry. And after that, after writing 4 list box or 4 data passing from this sheet, I will increase the arrow value. Arrow plus 1, and then next. And okay, just I am now describe the data. I am now describe the data or the code you. For this, as you see that the arrow equal to 2. After that, I go to y equal to 0 to arrow a. Here, 0 means that when you see this list box, or when you use this list box, the first value of this list box, you see that all the data came here, the position is of number 1 equal to 0, and after that the position of here, the number will be, sorry, here 1, and this is Kakoli B. The position of this cell is 01, and on the same way it is 02, okay, and on the same way it is 03, and after that here the row number is 1, that is this row number is 0, this row number 1 2 3 4 5, in this way. Okay, so for this I just write here, so I want to count this 0 cell, and for as I write want to write a loop and want to count this, so my first counted data will be start from 0, and E row A, here E row equal to there, and the position will be 9, sorry, so here E row equal to, as you see that there E row is equal to plus 1, that means 9, so I deduct here 3 data, okay, number 1 this cell, number 1 this cell, that is 2 1 2, and another is 0. As we start this loop from 1, we can deduct data minus 2, but as we start it from 0, so we have to deduct 3 from this E row A. After that, as I want to add data in list box, so this is the code syntax, add data list 1 dot add item, and after the same previous way I want to the sheet SHWT sheet 1 cell value to here, so this is here, and it will go to list box, okay, it will go to list box, and list, and this is the list box position. So the list box position will be as I show you last time, that list box time will be, it's a start from 0, so its position will be 00, and after that its position will be 01. On the same way it will go here, and after that when the first data will be passed, then I will increase its one position value, because this position is changing when the loop is rounding, y's value will be changing, but I want to change also with this cell's row value, and for this cell's row value will be changed by this code, and on the first time when I start the loop of there, I initialize it 2, because I want to count it from 2 position, okay, not 1 position, because 1 is our header, so we will start the code from 2, so it is start from 2, and after pass the first data, that is number 1 Kakoli B 41 Bashabu Dhaka, and here after that I will increase the row value, and for that on second time when it will after completing of number 1 data, it will go here, and the data will be 2 plus 1, that means 3, and so it counts 3 row data, that is 2 Abid 33 Kolna, okay, and this is now our code, and you see that the data is appearing here. With this I do some work regarding this factor. The factor is, I will tell the column width value, just our first column width value, I do not want to see the first column width value, okay, so I write down here 0, and after that I want to, as the name will be display name, it will be 100 pixel, and after that the is no need to very much space, so I put it 30, and after that I assign 4 column is 70. Okay, 70, or it, you can write it 100. Okay, just see what is happening after assigning the column width. You see that the SL column is not displayed here now, and but I want actually to resize the column with this text box as it looks. Good. So it is now looking good. Okay, and my second task now will be add data to list box. So for adding data, I will write the code here, and I will go for it to my next tutorial. Thank you.